Oh, Celine, it's really a privilege and always lovely to have a conversation with you. And one of the things that I felt when I first met you is how much that we have in common. I think we've known about each other for many years. And when I met you just over a year ago, we just didn't stop talking because of the shared beliefs. The things you were doing that I found really exciting in terms of well-being and resilience. And so it just made sense to have a conversation with you to see if we can perhaps share our best suggestions that would help business leaders or anybody that's feeling perhaps uncertain, and I think that's a lot of people with everything that's going on right now. So I'm just thrilled that we're meeting again and having this cup of tea together.
Yes, so am I, so am I. And even you and I are feeling the impact of all of this in the sphere. I know you've recently been ill with the virus itself.
Yeah, that was a real shock. Kind of it took me 8, 9 days to get over. And it started with a sore throat. I had the fever and the breathlessness. And one of the things that I felt really helped me, Celine, was your recommendation to take the vitamins that you suggested. So, the vitamin C that I was taking, the zinc and copper that you rave about, ericaceae, garlic,
Love
and vitamin D3. Thank you so much for those suggestions. I'm really, really grateful. Yeah, and I'm fine now. And it feels like I've just recovered from almost like a normal bout of flu. And I think it's different for everyone, though.
And if you are taking supplements, you know, if anybody watching this, which is great. Don't stop eating though where the supplements actually come from in nature, which is plant-based foods. So try and eat a lot of color. So eat garlic and have leeks and onions and cabbages. And I'm specifically mentioning those vegetables, and I'd be happy to share a link and some recipe ideas to anybody who
Oh,
would like.
that would be really useful, I think. Yes.
Because those foods in particular help the liver and the gut to keep up your immune system.
Can you just explain to me a little bit more about the link between the immune system and inflammation?
Well, we know when the immune system is triggered, so say by the virus that potentially comes in, is that a process called inflammation increases in the body, which is a natural way to help the body fight off the external trigger that's come in. But inflammation that goes on for long can cause havoc, does cause havoc, increases our predisposition for many chronic diseases, can also increase aging. So you want to try and minimize inflammation. And plant-based foods are alkalining, which means that they minimize inflammation.
Yeah, that's really interesting. I don't know if you've come across grounding mats that you can buy from a website called groundology.com, where you put these sheets on your bed and you plug them in so that they're earthed and they're designed to reduce inflammation while you sleep. And yes, I've got one, not to sleep on, but just that I sometimes sit on. And that's quite useful. As a way of reducing. I don't know if you've heard about it.
I've heard about them. I haven't tried them. I was nodding my head when you initially said grounding because I thought you were perhaps going to give the suggestion of actually standing on earth and grass barefoot. So that's very good. So if you're able to during this time access a garden or when you're out for once a day for a walk in a park, to maybe take off your shoes and your socks and actually feel the ground.
Yes.
And that brings me to the conversation that I think we should be having around the virus, which is how the earth fits in. And I know that this is something that's particularly interesting and important to you, Nikki.
I've always been interested in metaphysical theories and the role that nature and man play in existing together in harmony. And it struck me that we over the years we have really rampaged and raped the planet of so many of her resources, and we've poisoned and created through our greed for consumerism and wanting more, that it feels that nature is reclaiming some time so she can reboot, get back into balance, and then serve humanity better. I know this is quite a soft spiritual kind of belief, but you know, when you see that the rivers in Venice are clear, when you hear people saying they can see the stars for the first time, when you feel, even noticing around here where I live that there's a purity, and it's sunny now. We had so much rain this year for so long, and suddenly it feels like the earth is breathing again. And I can't help but question, is there a bigger force at play here over and above, you know, the things that we are reading about in the media every day?
Yeah, and as this whole thing started unfolding for me, I found myself asking and almost craving for more existential conversations around what this means for us. And, you know, some people have said to me, oh, they can't wait to get back to normal. And I don't want to go back, because that wasn't really normal based on what you've just shared.
Don't you think that's part of the problem, that we are, it's very easy to get very attached to the old way, and we're trying to hold on to the old way. And this is why people are in such denial, you know, last weekend, that, you know, so many people were at the parks and, you know, almost like ignoring the fact that this was happening. And I don't think they were doing it deliberately, but they just couldn't process the enormity of what was happening. And all the time we want things to go back to the old way, we are not being present in the now right now. And we're not able to recognize that there are gifts, there are opportunities, there are things, we're being called to have a quiet time of pause and reflection right now. We're being asked to be still rather than to fight against the natural inclination of things. Our natural kind of way is, oh, I need to fight and make this right. I need to go out and get business. I need to do this or do that, because the panic of that creates a momentum that you need to do. And I really believe that we're being called to just be right now.
And Nikki, on that note of just being, I think, and being in the moment, we need to also honor ourselves by expressing what we're feeling, be it grief or, I mean, I had in the first week, I couldn't believe how it almost felt like on an inspiration, I would feel in control, everything's going to be okay. And in the same breath as I exhaled, I went into complete despair and sadness because of what's going on. So we need to release these emotions, right? Because if we don't, this is part of the work that I've experienced with you, that I know that you do for countless others, is to help them express them.
And that's such a good point, because if you think that dealing with these really strong, intense emotions is by suppressing them and pushing them down, which a lot of people do, Celine, because they think, if I don't feel it, then it I've dealt with it. But it's still in our system, creating imbalance within our system. And it doesn't take much for that negative, unprocessed emotion to be triggered, especially under stressful environments right now. So allowing yourself to just feel fear, sadness, grief, anger, whatever those feelings are, is really, really important. Really important.
And to perhaps be compassionate towards those in your household that are going to go through the same things, and not take it personally. So understand that each of us are going to have different waves of emotions. And can I do a shout out for your expansion process? Because I think you launched that at just the right time. Because in the last week, I've done it 3 times and felt the benefits of it.
It's a bit crazy, but I think what makes it powerful is that primal releasing that blends with the breath work and the meditation and a lot of the other things. I'm really excited about it. And I just wanted to make it available for free to as many people as I can. So I have, as you know, you've seen the video tutorial, although I'm slightly kind of embarrassed when I see myself on camera, like I like that. It's a bit mad, but it's it feels so cathartic, doesn't it?
It does. I mean, I did the first one, the 45 minutes, and the level of, I felt like I was almost not on my bed, yet felt very supported. So I love that you gave us permission to just go crazy. And actually, you go crazy in quite a quiet way, and you're on your bed. So it's not like you're making, there's nothing to feel embarrassed about. I mean, and at the end, I did feel as light as a feather.
Yeah. Well, you actually are as light as a feather. You're tiny. There's nothing made much of you anyway. I was going to say that I think we're both quite keen to share over the coming months ideas and suggestions. And they are just our suggestions, aren't they, Celine? For that may just help a little bit. People to feel just a little bit more calm, a little bit more in balance, a little bit more in flow, so that they're ready to be ready to reemerge into the new way of being.
Yes. So we'd like to invite you, if you're listening to this, to, if you have any questions or comments, to post them, to contact us. I can highly recommend trying Nikki's new expansion process. Watch the tutorial. She does look a bit mad in it, but it gives you permission to get a bit mad and wild.
And I hope you're going to share the link to your recipes and your the vitamins that you talk about a lot. That would be really great. So thank you so much. And wherever you are, whatever you're doing, take care.
Bye for now.